followed that with an original of mine, and it's my main claim to fame. I gave a copy of this tune to Bill Evans, the great pianist, and to my wonder, 3 years later, he recorded it. And I was thrilled, of course. The only thing I didn't like is he used electric piano on it, and I wish he hadn't done that. But, you know, beggars can't be choosers. Anyway, this is a tune called Driftin'. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Now, before any more time goes by, I want to make sure you know these gentlemen who honor me with their presence on the stage are wonderful musicians, wonderful human beings, and just great to be around. And it's my pleasure to introduce to you Lynn Seaton on bass. And Richard DeRosa on drums. This is where I usually say, I'm Elton John. I can't help it. I wanted to be a stand-up comedian, but it just didn't work out. You know?
Well, at least you're standing up.
I'm a standing-up comedian. We're going to continue with an oldie but goldie from Chick Corea now, called 500 Miles High.
Thank you.
Thank you.
arrangement of Body and Soul, great standard by Betty Comden and Johnny Green. And my arrangement was influenced by John Coltrane's arrangement. John Coltrane in the early 60s, late 50s, early 60s, wrote several pieces that remain the most challenging to jazz musicians around the world. And but there's a thing called a giant steps turnaround, a progression of fifths and thirds, and move things around in keys very rapidly. And so what he did, I'll just show you, in the bridge, in the middle section of Body and Soul, he inserted a fragment from a piece called Countdown. So. Okay, so that's the first little piece of music he inserted into Body and Soul. And then if you go on from there, fit beautifully. I still like to play Body and Soul the original way too, the way Betty Comden and Johnny Green wrote it, but I like this direction. It's a little different flavor to it. So be listening in the bridge, because that's what we'll be doing. Thank you. you very much. That was Body and Soul. We're going to continue with another original of mine called Soulmates. And I believe we have all kinds of soulmates in life, our husband or wife, our loved ones in the family, our good friends, close friends, our students, our teachers, many kinds of soulmates. These are some of my soulmates right here. We all can kind of bond and relate in many ways, and I think that's a healthy thing, and we need to keep working on it. So here's Soulmates.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. You've been a great audience, and we appreciate your turning out tonight. We just have a couple more tunes for you. This next tune is a piece by Keith Jarrett called Standing Outside that I transcribed off an old trio record long time ago. Gosh, I can't remember. In fact, I don't think I want to tell you how long ago it was. But it's an unusual little piece called Standing Outside by Keith Jarrett.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. We're going to close with one more original of mine. And this is what we call a contrafact. Thelonious Monk was known for writing a lot of contrafacts, where he used the harmony of some existing standard song, like Just You, Just Me, or something, and wrote his own melody to it. And it's fun to do, and also to give it a different treatment. Actually, I usually tell people that this is a collaboration between me and Victor Young. Victor Young wrote this great song called Stella by Starlight. And I said, well, Victor, that's really great, but you know, would you mind if I wrote my own melody and put it into 3/4 and made it twice as long? Well, actually, Victor didn't know anything about it. He hadn't been around for quite a while. But anyway, if he's listening, I hope he approves. So we're going to do my version of Stella by Starlight, which I call Starbright. Thank you. piece by Horace Silver, great pianist, composer, band leader, made a huge contribution to our music. We lost him several years ago, but he's one of my favorite composers. All his compositions are interesting and are beautiful, and the one I'm going to play for you is especially beautiful. It's a very touching piece. I can't even talk about it, really, without kind of losing it. It's a piece, P-I-E-C-E, called Peace, P-E-A-C-E. And in our troubled times in this world these days, we need that, to find it one way or another. And music, of course, is a great place to find it. So we hope that you continue to find peace in music. So here's Horace Silver's piece.